Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Today we have a case where we'll show you a screw-retained restoration bridge on the upper jaw. We'll extract some of the teeth and then we'll have a temporary bridge on the teeth that we left, and later on we'll change the temporary bridge, the provisional bridge, to a zirconia bridge on top of those implants. You can see the pigmentation and you can see that the periodontal health of those teeth is not the best. We took some x-rays and we'll check the implant and check the teeth. The teeth need to be extracted and they're pretty much hopeless. You can't do anything really good for those teeth, and what we're going to show you is how we did all the procedures while leaving the patient with a temporary bridge that they can have some function with and not just the denture. The lower jaw isn't much better. It's basically the same. Sometimes it's easier to start off with one jaw to replace the teeth for the implants and later on do the other jaw because you maintain the same relations. You don't need to look for those relations again. And here you can see that from the canine and going backwards, it's a bridge. The patient has an occlusion. If you extract all the lower teeth and these upper teeth, then you need to find again the right occlusion of this patient. So in this case, it's much easier to change the upper teeth to a bridge on implants and later on the lower teeth as well. Doing it step by step in some cases is even easier for the patient because first of all, psychologically, you change some of these teeth and he's left with some other teeth and it doesn't have a bleeding pain all over his mouth. It depends on every case. Sometimes you want to change everything at once. Sometimes you want to do it periodically. You can see that three teeth remained. Those teeth were extracted. The teeth that remained, we made root canal treatment, and post and core were cemented to these teeth for the temporary bridge to have a better retention on those teeth. Now, everything is temporary. Later on, we'll extract those teeth as well, but we wanted those teeth to last at least 4 to 6 months until the implants will osseointegrate and we'll have a better temporary bridge, and later on, a permanent zirconia bridge. This one is probably a PFM bridge, porcelain fused to metal. Probably when the bridge was made, the height of the porcelain wasn't small enough, and when the doctor checked the occlusion, it needed to be removed from this spot. So they removed it until he got to the metal. Most likely, some part in the occlusion taking was wrong, which is why all of this happened in the first place. You need to really look for the metal. If it was in the buccal parts, the bridge was probably remade, but here is probably broken. Maybe something happened, maybe they removed the porcelain after the cementation of the bridge. You can have many different reasons why you should leave it. Maybe there is not enough space between the prepared upper tooth and the lower tooth, so there wasn't even a cement porcelain placed in this area. Because it's a temporary bridge that is cemented on only three teeth, you need to have a massive temporary bridge. You can't have a temporary bridge where all the embrasures and the gingiva and everything looks good, because every embrasure you make, you weaken the bridge. When you weaken the bridge, in this case, there can be fractures. There'll be a lot of issues. You want for this bridge to hold at least for 3 months until you can load those implants, and to honestly, maybe it's even better than there were before. There are many considerations. When you're performing a temporary bridge, you need to think about all of this stuff. So in this case, probably the temporary bridge was made a little bit thicker for it not to break down. The gingiva will heal, the implant will osseointegrate. We'll see how the gingiva healed, so we'll know in the future parts what type of multi-unit we should use, how we would design the crowns around the gingiva. So we will have the nice continuity between the gingiva and the teeth themselves. We chose the right multi-units for every implant by the height of the multi-unit. You can see by the color of the multi-units that there are different types of multi-units and how many there are. You can see that this tooth has many caries, that even the core that we used was removed with the bridge. The bridge that was cemented on, so these teeth are in really bad condition. In this case, we took impressions of those multi-units. Later on, after the healing and swelling of the gingiva, you can maybe change one or two of the multi-units, but it's much easier to take impressions on a multi-unit level. We took impressions on multi-unit level on all of the multi-units, but we didn't extract the teeth because in this case, you put back the bridge that we took off before and the patient waits for a new bridge to be constructed. You just wait for the manufacturing of the new bridge. The new bridge will go on top of the multi-unit, and to put the bridge on top of the multi-unit, we need to extract those teeth. So we'll have two operations in one day. We'll have the extraction of the teeth and the assembly of the bridge, but we already chose the multi-units based off our impressions. The patient waits depending on how long it takes to make the bridge. If you had a CAD/CAM machine or you send it elsewhere, it would probably take 1 day to a week. Here you can see the bridge. You can see the screw channels here. Some go very buckly. Later on, you can make changes, the multi-units to angulated ones, because you didn't have the design of the bridge before. So you don't know what type of multi-unit you can use and if you're going to have any problem with angulation. But even though it goes to the buccal part, you see it in the distal part of the canine. So maybe if you close it up, you won't see the screw channel. You can see the extraction of the teeth and the multi-unit, which can look a little bit messy. We have 5 multi-units, and here you can see the teeth, and here you can see the sockets of the teeth. Here, you can see the PMMA bridge. We're closing the holes with the plastic pins. You can see the angulation of all of these implants, and you can see that the implants are practically parallel, so you don't have any buccal inclination. Just on these 2 implants, you have slightly inclined implants, which is fine because it's the upper jaw. Sometimes it's very hard to place implants parallel, or it goes a little bit palatal, so it was a really, really great job well done. You can see the scans, and you can see the design, and you can see the final design of the crowns. You can see that there are no significant changes between the original teeth and the end result that you get. Some patients don't want to have any noticeable changes in the final crowns and the original teeth that they have. They don't want people to know that they have implants. They want people to think that it's all natural. So we keep the original design, we take this design, and we design the new teeth by the original design. You can see also that even though we extracted the teeth, you would think that there was a little bit of a gingival recession. But in this case, instead of having a gingival recession, the gingival healed and you have more gingiva than before. Because we extracted the problematic teeth, there's much less inflammation and the implants are maintained correctly as they should be, and the gingiva is not inflamed as before. So the gingiva healed a little bit and returned to the original position. Here you can see the screw channel, the angulation of the screw channels and the angulation of the scan abutments on the multi-unit level. You can see the scan of the provisional bridge and you can see the scan of the original. What we wanted to show you here is not the final work, but you can see the gingival line. You can see that the gingival line here is very high, much higher than here. When you have an inflamed gingiva, even though you have teeth, not always will you have gingival recession if the procedure is done correctly. Now, there are different types of programs for designing. Most of the programs are probably the same. In this case, everything was made in exocad, in the latest version with the libraries of these multi-units and the design of the teeth with libraries, adjusting a little bit the screw channels. These libraries in exocad, even if it had gingival recession, for example, after you place the multi-units, you can still change the height of the multi-units without taking impressions again. You wouldn't need to remove the bridge, change the multi-units, take impressions, and send it back to the lab. The biggest advantage in these types of works is that you take one impression, and later on, if you want to change anything, you can change it according to the latest work that you designed. So if in here you wanted this multi-unit to be a little bit smaller or just a little bit higher, you could switch to a different multi-unit and the design would be still the same. You'll need to correct it a little bit because you changed the height of the multi-unit, but everything is made really easy. So you have one provisional bridge going into the second provisional bridge. It's very easy because you can just replace the upper jaw scan. You have the occlusion because we made only the upper jaw. And later on, all you need to do is just change the height of the multi-unit. You can see how the gingiva changed according to the original scan. You make these small adjustments and you have everything done. You can see the bridge and then the gingiva as well as the teeth that are almost touching the gingiva. You won't have any pockets between the gingiva and the bridge, and the aesthetic looks great. The color looks fine. The most important thing is the design. The design looks very close to the original teeth with the coloring looking exactly as the porcelain. You don't see any changes in the color and you see the relations between the bridge and the gingiva. You see a very healthy, maintained gingiva, which is great for implants. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. See you guys next time.